So.
Are you gay?
Yes.
How long have you been in New York?
3 years.
How was your dating experience here?
You know, not great, but that's a me problem, I would say.
I like the self-awareness. So why do you think it's hard here, besides that it's your problem?
Honestly, the fact that there is so many people and so many gay people can actually make it difficult as opposed to easier.
Think there is too much competition or what?
Not even the competition, more than like options. And like, it's just like, and also hookup culture is weird. There's a lot of people. A lot.
So when you say it's a you problem, it's hard for you to stick with one option?
Yeah, I would say yeah.
There is a prophecy in the Bible that foretells a time that would come upon the earth as a result of God's judgment because of the people's idolatry. There would come a time where the options of men and the availability of men would be so scarce that women would be willing to share the men. Women would be willing to be seven women per man. And they would be willing to lower their standards and take on the roles and duties that a man ought to just for the sake of having a man, just to avoid the shame of singleness. Isn't that crazy? That's Isaiah 4:1. Now, I believe that we are seeing the manifestation of that prophecy in this present time. It was applicable to the time back then, but it is happening even now because we are seeing the rise in polyamorous relationships.
This your lady? This your lady?
Both of my ladies.
Yeah. How much you'll charge me to have them for the night, bro?
If you don't get out my face, nigga.
Say it again?
If you don't get out my face.
No, I'm saying you don't got a brace.
Get out my face.
It's a prank, bro. Chill out.
I don't know, okay,
it's no need to be mad, bro. Calm down. Stop drinking. God damn it.
And we are seeing women who are willing to share a man, a high value man, just because it is so rare to get one. It's so awesome and special to have one that they just accept and even embrace sharing that man with other women.
If this wasn't true, look at these jokes that women make about being with a rich guy. She's acting like nothing's happening and she's not going to start a fight because she wants to keep her lavish lifestyle. This girl says, Lamau, I would have done the same thing. See, this is a woman saying that. So this is kind of showing that some women would rather share a high value man than be with someone that don't have their life together or can't make life convenient for them. And if that wasn't proof enough for you, here's another one.
Hey, babe, what do you think of my outfit? Oh my God. Where are my manners? Did you need anything for afterwards? Cold water? Sandwich? Cold water. Okay. He actually likes that, by the way. You look good. Okay.
Could never be me, okay? Never. Don't let it be you either. You're... Now, it is my belief that this has a lot to do with the fact that men are laying with other men. Men are choosing to lay with other men. Men are giving over to homosexuality increasingly. Many men are gay right now. Many of them. What's good? My name is Crystal Nicolaio. Thank you for stopping by and tuning in. So, just in case you're new, the purpose of this channel is to preach the truth, expose the lies, and to address the big fat elephants in the room that may trigger and offend some people, which I don't too much care about, okay? I care about you being set free, and it is the truth that will set you free. Yay, okay? Look, when I was living out in Manhattan, New York, going to my dramatic arts school, I feel as if 90% of the men were gay. That was crazy. Like, I even had an experience where a man was trying to combat me and compete with me to get another man's attention. Yo, it was crazy. But none of this should come as a surprise to us because the Bible did foretell that in the last days it would be like Sodom and Gomorrah. Sodomy, homosexuality, lust, whoredom, craziness going on. The Bible foretold that the time would come and we are living in the manifestation of that hour right here, right now. We are in Pride Month, which made me deem it fit to release this video and this revelation that God gave to me to share with you today. Not only is it an awesome revelation just to have your eyes opened, but it's something for you to look out as straight as you may be. God showed me a way that spirit can creep in within the lives of even the most heterosexual individual of them all, okay? So as I was scrolling on Instagram in 2020, I saw this couple and they were very beautiful. Like, they were mutually attractive. She was a very beautiful young lady. He was a very handsome young man. So naturally, you know, I already knew who my person was. Naturally, I was just, you know, mindlessly scrolling, or so I thought. Eventually, I picked up on something as I was looking at the man. She was having his baby and all, okay? And it was clear that this young man could pull anybody he wanted, all right? And so I went to his profile just to see if what I'm discerning and seeing with my eyes, if I'm seeing with my mind's eye or my Holy Spirit eyes. As I went to his profile, I saw him posted up with other young men. And ain't nothing wrong with that. Men have male friends. That's normal. That's natural. But the same spirit that I saw upon him, I saw upon his friendship circle as well. What was clear to me was that they lay either with each other or other men alike. They were consumed and overtaken by that pride. The LGBTQIA+ community is overtaken. They are slaves to their sin. They are overtaken by the lust of the eyes, the lust of the flesh, and the pride of life. And we are in Pride Month, okay? The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. That's what the world calls it. That's not what God calls it. But we're in Pride Month. They parade their pride. They parade their lust.
I was surprised to come across this scripture.
It says this, "The look on their faces testify against them. They parade their sin like Sodom. They do not hide it. Woe to them. They have brought disaster upon themselves."
I'm going to highlight two scriptures to you. I've referenced them on this channel before, and I will continue to in days and weeks and months to come because they've just been piercing and very prevalent for me in this hour. So, paraphrase, a shortening of the scripture, "In the last days, men will be lovers of themselves. Their hearts will grow cold." What was clear to me, and here's the revelation, this man and other men like him are so consumed with pride and their unholy love for themselves that they say within their hearts, to just be with a woman is not enough. To be with several women is not enough. What I need and what my pride needs is for a man to bow down to me, a man to bend over for me. A man is called to be the head of the household. God had given me this revelation, and it's why we hear about the kind of dealings that P. Diddy got going on.
Yeah, I love this drink. Will you put my bag? I like when you like this, Daddy. Yeah, will you put my bag? Daddy, I like when you scrambling and scraping. I like that.
You know, I've been practicing.
I heard this rapper who I will insert a clip of. God confirmed it when I listened to him speak. I thought I was tripping when God downloaded this information to me. I shared it with a friend of mine named Sammy, a brother in Christ. I thought I was just tweaking and making it up until this man, this rapper, said it out of his own mouth.
We have you. You're on Instagram, you're posting a half t-shirt, and you're saying, "I'm bisexual, I like females and males."
For sure.
Now, take us through that. Take us through that. What made you post that? Take us through that whole ordeal, that whole situation.
What made me post it? Because, like, for real. I was just saying how I feel for real. Like, on some real shit. On some, you know? Don't get me wrong, I ain't out here sucking no and getting in the ass and stuff like that. But, you feel what I'm saying? I'll make a nigga my. Like, you wanna be my. I'll make a motherfucker my. Quick. Like, I don't get no. Like, I ain't out here looking at motherfucker. Like, yeah, I want him, I want that. It's like, nah, I got a certain type. I like transgender. Like that, I like feminine, cause I'm masculine, so I'm a motherfucking king. I come from king's royalty. I like power, so shit, you know.
I like power, so shit.
When did you accept that that's who you were? Did you been knowing, like?
Nah,
it's a power thing. It's a power thing for men to bend down for me. It's a power thing to reduce who is supposed to be the masculine head of the household, to reduce himself to that of a woman and put me in a position as if I am a god. It is pride. It is lust. It is unclean. It is filthy. Out of his own mouth, this rapper say that it's a power thing. He was a heterosexual man in a community that is changing right now, but in a rap community, a hip-hop community that is very pro-masculinity for the men, being able to pull several women and play these women and all of that. But here was a man who has been so overtaken by his greed, his lust, his pride, that he wanted men in his midst as well. This is nothing new. There are certain things that men are confronted by the enemy to do to climb the ladder in the industry. And make no mistake, it's even within the church. I did some research within the Sangoma
religion, the demonic religion, the doctrines of devils, the powers and principalities within that, God led me to do some research on that.
There is one-on-one pit of hell. There is prophecy from hell. There is tongues from hell. Hmm. You understand? You hear Pastor.
To disguise the language of
Pastor is talking to his God. And not you are busy. Receive, receive. You've received. No problems. Your head. Men are troublesome. That guy's sacrifice, it cannot maintain.
Yeah, it's
It cannot. It's very hard when they tell you to sleep with about 60 men per month. It's not easy.
Some Pentecostal and charismatic churches around the world today are driven by external spiritual forces that are unknown. Pastors, apostles, prophets perform bizarre miracles that are questionable. But this expose tells us where these so-called powers come from. Certainly not from God. He is a well-known priest in his native Ghana with a surname which means the devil. Kweku Bunsam claims he has given over 4,000 pastors worldwide powers. This is to enable them to perform miracles, signs, and wonders.
You always normally let some of the pastors, the pastors is the one who is their problem. They are the one who created confusion. They are the one who talk to people to put in their mind. There is nobody here. Every day I do consultation, I sit down like this, I look at 500 people a day for consultation. Every day 500. If I say, I didn't come and say, I do this for people. But I can say maybe I have some pastors, 4,987 pastors in the world that I help them. I give them juju to do their churches. I use this my five finger to say I give them juju to do their church. It's very serious.
Not once, twice, or thrice has he said this.
Listen, be careful when you see people prophesying accurately, performing signs and wonders, yet something seems off about it. Some of the people that you may be watching, you don't even know that some of these people have laid with other men to obtain more power. You don't even know the things that some people are doing.
Now, coming to people who have multiple sexual relationships, this is the reason. The powers which are given to them, they require life. Now, life in which form? In a form that it must be transmitted to other people, and women are targets. And some of them, I'm sorry to say this, they don't only sleep with women, but they sleep also with men. Because of the purpose is to transmit the demon that is in them into the lives of those people. And the victims, what happens to the victims, this I will say it loud and clear without apologizing, what happens to the victim's lives, number one, if the victim does not get delivered, I don't speak about being prayed for, falling down, but change from reading the word of God, the life of the victim will become worse. If she is a married woman, she will now start to have affairs, because now the demon is now living inside of her, making her to begin to crave, making her to begin to have the spirit of lust, that an uncontrollable lust. This is what I'm referring to. Now, the more these people, they even fornicate with other people, it is the more they get this success, material success. So the purpose of these people who sleep with their church members, and they don't just sleep with their church members, Mr. Solomon, they look at those who have a gift. Number one, if you have a gift where people can listen to you, or you are a charismatic person, those are the target people. If you are a brilliant person, they need the gift so that they can use the gift for the kingdom of darkness. So they don't just sleep with any person. They've got their own specific target. And once they have slept with those people's lives become worse. And this is how they do it. they don't just come and approach a person literally and say, this is what, or this is my intention. They summon the spirit of lust. Remember, you have used their water. Some of them, they even wear the church uniform. Yeah. And now you have open an access in your spirit for this God of the church, because there is God of the church.
This is why you cannot be enamored by powers, by signs, wonders, and miracles. The son of perdition will perform signs, wonders, and miracles. We're seeing that same Antichrist spirit at work today. So just because somebody is professing Christ and all of that and acting like they are of Christ, but denying him in certain ways, do not be seduced and charmed. Do not be bewitched by accurate information. As I always say, familiar spirits can give you accurate information as well, okay? Now look, I even was watching a Jim Jones documentary, not the rapper, but the man who went completely insane as a Christian. This man was so consumed by power and greed.
Edie? Fingers, are your fingers numb? In your right hand, reach the fingers out that are bothering you. Now, is the pain gone?
There was a senior citizen, and we nicknamed her Power. He would have her to come up in the midst of one of his meetings, and she used to say, "The man got power. The man got power, y'all." And the whole place would just go wild.
This man was so consumed by power and greed that he...
I had been in the temple for just a few months. I was sent backstage in Los Angeles to get something for somebody. I don't remember what. And Jones happened to be coming out of his room. And he said, "Hi, Tim, how are you doing? How's it going? How do you like everything so far?" And, "Oh, I like it a lot. And, you know, it's really cool." I don't remember exactly. And he reached up and kind of patted the back of my neck. And he said, "I'll f*** you in the ass if you want." And I just kind of stammered, "No, you know, no." And he said, "Well, you know, if you ever want that, that's okay. You know, just let me know and we'll do that."
This is nothing new, but we will see homosexuality increase significantly in this time where people are building their own towers of Babel, where God is not in the midst, and they're trying to get that validation. They're trying to get that status. They're trying to be lowercase g gods in this time. Another revelation that God gave me was the scripture James 3:16. I will paraphrase this. Where there's envy and strife, other versions say where there's envy and selfish ambition. God has been highlighting the selfish ambition to me. Where there's envy and selfish ambition, there's every evil practice, every unclean way. Okay? So when you are seeking hierarchy and you're seeking the validation of man, that pride will open up the door, that lust, that unclean spirit will open up a door to an individual becoming so power hungry that uncleanliness avails them to not only desire people's approval and applause and submission even, but it desires even the attraction of the same sex. This is why we got to check ourselves in the name of Jesus, be transformed by the renewing of our minds and decrease as he increases, because we are living in a wicked, perilous time. We are living in a time when people are building their own towers of Babel and God is not in the mix of it. And they think God is in the mix because it seems to be succeeding. It is developing. It is growing super large and super big. But in the midst of it all, their desire is to be a lowercase g god in this land right now.
What's a king to a god? What's a god to a non-believer who don't believe in anything?
When that unclean spirit gains access to this perverted heart and mind, it only increases that person's lust and perversion. that Jezebel's spirit ain't got no type. After all, the depiction of Satan is oftentimes a breasted man. It has no type. I will never forget this one time when I heard a man of God, I believe he was a pastor, I could be mistaken, but he was some form of a leader, if not in the church, in his house at least, right? But I believe he was the leader of a church, and he was confessing how he had been given over to pornea and struggling with pornography. And he said that he got so perverted, so consumed by that unclean spirit, that he even began to look at animals some kind of way. I will never forget that, you guys, never. I won't forget it. That unclean spirit, it doesn't care what it is, it doesn't care what you are. Like, why do you think that they keep on adding letters into the LGBTQIA+ community? Like, they were even trying to add pedophilia. There were discussions of adding bestiality, because all of these things are included within that cesspool of sin. There is no type, there is no end to it. And it reminds me of the day when the mark of the beast will come. I believe the son of perdition, the Antichrist, will be a homosexual himself, because the devil is perverted. He himself is a homo. He, you know, I got like sensitive real quick for the people who are like, oh my gosh, like not sensitive because I'm hurting, but I'm like, oh my gosh, is that offensive? Well, look, I don't care. I don't care what they may think of me. All right, anyways, though, for real, on that day when the son of perdition comes along, it's gonna be a cesspool. I believe that once the people receive the mark of the beast, they will not only be damned for hell, that is like the one time in history where we can say definitely that somebody will be going to hell once they receive that mark of the beast. I believe that once they do, they will have access to anything. Could you imagine? You could buy anything, you could do anything you want. There will be, you will literally be in a land of lawlessness. God forbid you will be, but this is the time that it will be. And I believe people will automatically become homosexual, perverted, lustful, demonized, possessed with any demon possible. It's gonna be a crazy time, and we're heading up to that right now. So these are the facts. But yeah, as I was saying, that unclean spirit, it doesn't care what it is, it doesn't care what you are. And I cannot tell you how many times I have been around men who profess to be gay and have looked at me some kind of way. Because when those eye gates are open to lust after the backside of a man, best believe they're open to lust after the backside of a woman as well. Because it is attracted to a piece of flesh, it is attracted to meat. So these men who would probably swear up and down that they would never lay up with a woman, who would probably gag at the idea, that lustful spirit ain't got no type, okay? Look, as much as this is a reality for men, this is a reality for women as well. I just felt led to hyper-focus on the man. But one thing that I know is that some women have been, I know one case in particular, she was not well received by men. She wasn't the most attractive out there. But she had her own kind of beauty, but it wasn't easy for her to get man's approval and attraction. She wasn't so much so received by many men all the time. And sometimes that's just how it goes. It's God. But other times, you know, it's a physical thing. It is what it is. God has somebody for anybody who he has called to marriage. But it does not exclude women as well. If you're struggling with pride and all of these other things, that can be an open door to the temptation of the sin and all that perversion. But one thing that I do know is that many women have been wounded by men or have been let down by men and have given themselves over to that homosexual lifestyle because that unclean spirit ain't got no type in that community. It receives many with open arms, and that's part of what gets people tricked. That's partially what gets people bewitched and ensnared. But validation comes from God alone. And I pray that you and I embrace this reality and that we come out from among them and be separate, because look, it's a crazy time right now, and many people are being consumed by pride. Anybody could be a lowercase g god. Anybody could be somebody online these days.
That's why I'm saying they are being taught by bigger
to do what?
Yeah.
Say this, tell them to receive.
They are being taught by bigger, huge false prophets. Because the big false prophets now are just pastors who are sitting and watching the dance. Mm.
Somebody said, wow. Grab a seat of 1,000. If you have it, move forward. Move forward. Stand right here.
They are sitting with their thing here, and then they leave. You see, you come, he makes you touch there, and you go. Go, my son, you just be giving tithe of your own church.
They will he submit you to.
Yeah, you to this thing then. So it's just a circle of demons.
So the success that they are getting is from that altar.
And it's now, even... you know, this thing is deeper than we see it and we say it. But it's not new. Christ warned us about it. Mm. You understand?
Edie? Fingers, are your fingers numb? In your right hand. Reach the fingers out that are bothering you. Now, is the pain gone?
It's done. It's done. This anointing is called a remote control.
It's crazy. And it's an eye-opener for us to be careful. It will continue to increase. It will continue to operate in some churches. It will continue to seduce men, and it will continue to leave us with fewer options. And I also believe that naturally, as the men are becoming increasingly scarce, there's more women amongst themselves, which I think plays a role in women giving over to lesbianism as well. But woman of God, man of God, if God has called you to marriage, he has someone for you. So please don't lower your standards, and please don't be out here sharing a man. Even Izana, fixed my life. I even heard this woman talking about she will share her man. This woman who has been about bringing families together and instilling order. She has been seduced by that doctrine and by that way, this unclean spirit in this time. I pray she repents because her influence is very influential. So, all right, that is pretty much it, okay? I pray that this was a major blessing to you, and please do share it with somebody. Maybe it will set somebody free in some way, shape, or form. Knowledge sets God's children free, okay? And let me leave you with this fact. I know Pride Month is ending. It is what it is. This will always be true, and I may change the years within the title as the years go on, because it's going to continue to be true. But the homosexual, the sodomite, will not enter into the kingdom of God. This is the reality. These are the facts. But some people in the faith used to be homosexuals. They have been healed, transformed, made into a new creation through Christ. It's possible. And Jesus wants to do that for you. He wants to heal you and set you free, because if you look at it with sober eyes, it is a sort of illness. It is a sort of disease spiritually. It does lead to death. You could tell that this rapper doesn't have a clear conscience about his choices.
Now,
you could see it.
Take us through that. Now,
but as for you, I pray that God heals you and delivers you from every wound that has inflicted you and any trauma, any perversion. I pray he transforms you by the renewing of your mind. And I pray that you give your life to Christ and choose this day which God you serve and believe. All you have to do is believe and live that repentant lifestyle. Turn away from that sin, turn away from that unclean life, and receive the fact that he died on the cross in your place and rose on the third day so that you and I could rise and be seated with him in heavenly places and not be on the bad side of God on that day of judgment. What a terrible day it's going to be. And you don't want to be on the wrong side of God, but he has so much redemption in store for you, not only in this lifetime, but in the next. So I pray that you embrace him and love him, because he loves you so much no matter what you have done. And Jesus is Lord, and the truth is the truth, and Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life, and whom the Son sets free is free indeed. Okay. because these are some serious times. All I could see around us is just violence and crime. Full time for us to socialize. I forget the lyrics, but yeah, it's a crazy time right now. So pull yourself together and be blessed in the name of Jesus. I will see you in the next one. My name is Cristo Nicole Isle, and that'll be changing soon. Boom, 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 boom. Later. Bye.